Welcome to DCP Transfer. DCP Transfer gives you a set of tools to deliver your DCP to theaters and festivals with confidence. With these tools, you can properly format an off-the-shelf USB drive according to the proper digital cinema specs, validate that your DCP is complete and not corrupt, and get info about a DCP using the package inspector. To get started, we'll need a DCP, which you may have made yourself or had professionally created. It might already be on an external drive, or you may have downloaded it from the web. For this example, I'm going to use this DCP on my desktop. We'll also need a drive to copy the DCP onto. I'm going to be using this thumb drive called adata UFD. So let's go ahead and launch DCP Transfer. Here we can see that the interface is divided into two sections. On the top, there's the source panel, and on the bottom, there's the destination panel. The source panel is where you'll load the DCPs to be copied, and the destination drive is where they'll be copied to. You can select the destination drive here. So let's load a DCP into the source panel. You can do this in one of a few ways. You can click the plus button. You can select File, Add DCPs. You can double-click the background of the source panel. Or you can right-click the source panel and choose Add DCPs. It should be noted that if you try to add a DCP that is missing files or has something wrong with it, you'll get this warning. So now that we've got a DCP in the source area, we can do a couple things with it. So let's first check out the package inspector. You can show the inspector panel by clicking the blue eye at the bottom right-hand corner of the interface, or by selecting a DCP and hitting Command-I. The inspector shows you information about the package like encryption status, content kind, frame size, frame rate, duration, audio information, and more. To hide the package inspector, click on the blue eye button or hit Command-I. Another thing you might want to do is validate the drive format to check to see if the drive adheres to the digital cinema specs. In order to verify the drive format, DCP Transfer quickly unmounts and remounts the drive and either displays a green checkmark or red X. This particular drive isn't formatted properly for DCP, so it gets a red X. Since we're ready to create our delivery drive, let's click Transfer DCPs. Here we have a few options. We can validate the source DCPs before transfer. We can format the drive. Since our drive is not currently formatted correctly, we are forced to format. If a DCP with the same name already exists in the drive, there's an option to overwrite colliding DCPs. And finally, we can automatically validate the DCPs after the transfer is done. So let's type a name in for our drive. I like to use all caps for my DCP drives, and I try to keep the name as short as possible. All right, all of our options are selected. Let's hit transfer. The first thing that will happen is the DCPs that are loaded into the source area will be validated. Then the drive will go through the formatting process, after which the DCPs will be copied to the drive. Once all the DCPs have been transferred, the validation process will automatically run on the copied DCPs. After everything is finished, we get a completion report reminding us what took place and the results of everything. Most importantly, DCP Transfer lets me know that this drive is currently ready for delivery. That means I can have the confidence that the drive is ready to be shipped out to any digital cinema in the world.